This is the belly. So on the belly, we're going to separate the ribs. And these would be the spare ribs from the belly, which is going to give us our bacon and spare ribs. So depending on how you do it or what you like the best, it's all in preference. We prefer more bacon than meatier spare ribs. So I'm going to follow my knife along the ribs very closely, scraping the ribs, keeping as much of the meat on the bacon or on the belly as possible for the bacon. As a reference, this is upside down. This is the bottom of the pig. This would have been the front, top, back. And you can see it's already kind of starting to separate itself. And you want to take as long as cuts as possible along here and not short cuts. There you go.
Go upstairs and get a drink, Bob. Yeah, just don't wake up the baby yet.
As you get to the top, you'll start to see where a natural separation is going to occur. Spare ribs and your bacon. A lot of people will take and clean up the edges, just where it flaps, and you're not going to get good slices of bacon out of that anyhow. So you would square that off. That would go into cut up for sausage or whatever, ground. Square off the back side. You've got a big layer of just the fat at the top. Cut that off to go into your lard pile. If you need to fit this into a small smoker or something, you would then just cut it in half. We don't need to do that, so we're just going to leave ours whole and cure them. And see, bacon in.